Say, did y'all lose power yesterday, too? Yeah, when the lights went out, there I was cooking dinner. Oh, well, if we're getting specific, I was nuking a half-eaten burrito I found wedged in my couch cushions. Yeah, I know I shouldn't have. After all, I heard microwaves zap out all the nutrients. But, hey, it kills the cockroaches, too, so, you know, you win some, you lose some. Anyway, what was I... Right, the power outage. Apparently some plant out in Santo short-circuit. Heard the EMPs were knocking AVs out of the sky. The CPD says the blackout led to 120 mil in damages all in all. The real tragedy, though? I can't stomach a cold burrito.
120 million eddies? Hot damn. And just to get your hands on one dude. You got some cojones, V.
Sure, we can pack, we can ride, But what then?
The contract's dead. We've got no reason to stay.
You're the only ones breaking camp.
Because Saul doesn't know when to quit. He's stubborn as a mule. Yet everyone listens to him because...
Because he's head of the family? Because the Aldecaldas stay together?
God damn it. Have it your way. We'll stay.
No. The rest will stay here in camp. I want patrols every half hour, reporting directly
v,
to me.
You're here.
What is she doing here? I forbade you from even breathing on that Militech convoy, so you call in your friend? To do it all behind my back? Is that it?
Uh-huh. That's exactly why I had V come and stand right in front of you. Do you think
I've got no fucking clue what's going on here.
Damn it to hell, Saul. Are you seriously considering letting that basilisk slip through our fingers?
I am.
But a chance like this?
A chance at what? Rotting up the job we came here to do? We're pissing Militech off, so they hammer us into the dirt right here.
Shit! Pan Am, can you please tell him?
I've already tried. Let it go, Mitch.
The Biotechnica people will be here in an hour. Try not to cock anything else up before then.
I can't believe it. Look, there he goes, off to paint the grass green.
What's this basilisk nonsense?
It's an armored Militech cargo panzer. Junk from back in 2060 or so. They want to peddle it off to a backwards country, somewhere it can still pass as a technological wonder.
The Militech convoy will take the 101 right past us. Shame not to say hello.
This basilisk worth another fight with Saul?
Yes, a craft like that would finally put us back on the right path.
The family is falling apart. If we fall into this Biotechnica rut, no one will ever take us seriously again.
Okay, so you do want to go behind Saul's back. Dragged me here specifically for that.
Cassidy, Ted, Carol, and Bob, also on board.
Why Saul got his briefs in a bunch over this basilisk?
He's afraid Militech will destroy us if we pick a fight with it.
He thinks it's safer to stick with the corporations, like Biotechnica. What a joke.
And you guys would rather...
We would rather go back to plying the trade we know best. Logistics.
Meaning smuggling.
That's what I said.
And you plan to grab the basilisk, how?
Thanks, V.
Haven't said I'd help just yet.
Okay, let's go talk to the rest.
So, just the four vets on board with the plan. Nobody else.
We didn't bother asking the others.
There was too great a risk someone would take it to Saul.
Besides, only the vets understand what we have to gain by having a basilisk.
Sounds pretty risky to me.
On the contrary, easy as pie. There won't even be much security on the convoy. Plus, we'll be doing our part towards furthering the cause of world peace. Why should this beast wind up being used in some little third world skirmish? We'll make better use of it right here in America.
Did you try to get Saul on board again? No luck, huh?
No. Okay, everyone listen. Militech will transport the basilisk in parts distributed across two trucks.
Wait, do I sense a quiver in your voice?
Fuck you! The convoy will halt at the railroad crossing on the 101. We'll attack from behind, then get the hell out and away. Questions? Comments? Motions?
Nice job, Sunshine.
Mm-hmm. Damn short, sweet, and pertinent. None of that sound.
Okay. I'm in.
Okay. Thanks. First, we'll ride to the station. The train engine we need to block the convoy's way is there. Are you riding with us, or will we meet you there?
Riding with you.
Excellent. Let's get going.
I think I heard a little shake in that voice.
You did not.
Come on. Did you get your hands clammy, too?
Screw you.
But are you sure you didn't leave any tracks? Militech won't notice a thing.
Are you trying to insult me, Bobby?
Okay, okay. Forget I even asked.
Nobody's gonna notice you gone back at camp?
Saul has no wish to see us there anyway. The better to make a good second impression on the Biotechnica suits.
Your sour faces wouldn't help much.
Indeed, they would not.
And the Raffens, what about them? Expecting any trouble?
Saul is. He's posted sentries all around the camp.
How is that not right?
He's wrong in continuing to fight the symptoms rather than the disease.
Don't miss life in Night City?
At times, perhaps. I miss the feeling of having a new beginning. Of freedom. But I also haven't forgotten the emptiness. The feeling of realizing it means nothing if you're alone.
Yeah. Took adjustment on my part, too. Though, never was completely alone.
You had someone?
A true friend. Jackie by name. You would have liked him, actually.
Jackie. I'll remember that. We have arrived.
Big bastard.
If you like it so much, maybe we should just hijack the train. Let the Basilisk go on its way.
Yeah, then just drive this beast to the 101. There and back.
Saul would be on board with that. Are we ready? Okay, the Militech convoy will be traveling from Night City to the base where they're due to meet the buyer. We will stop it at the railroad crossing.
All we have to do is shove this beauty in its way.
V, any questions?
Plan to move this thing how exactly?
It's old tech. Carol will have to hack it.
Then I'll somehow have to finagle authorization from the control tower to move it.
Tower looks inactive to me, too.
Yeah, we'll see to that. You and Pan Am just get the authorization code.
Okay, let's get to work. Boys. I've always been fond of trains. And the stations where so many tracks converge.
Junctions.
Yes, those. When you see them from above, you feel
free. Like you could set off on 1,000 journeys all at once.
Perhaps more simply, hopeful. Okay, here we are.
Carol! What are we looking for?
Punch cards!
What cards?
Oblong cards, holes in rows and columns.
Would you help me look?
Sure thing. Not here. Well,
okay,
well, well.
Must be here somewhere.
V, look thoroughly, please.
Got something.
Good job. Carol! We have a card! What now? You have to put it in the reader!
Well, V? The card. In the reader?
Goes nothing.
It worked. Come look.
Little engine that could.
V, I wanted to speak with you.
What do you want to talk about?
I know this may sound foolish, because I asked you to help me, but why are you doing this?
Because it's important to you.
But is that all? Sorry, that sounded worse than I intended.
Any more questions?
No, I know everything I need to, I believe. Perhaps I should send Rogue flowers to thank her for introducing us.
Not really your style, don't think.
I would add a card. Thank you for giving me a true friend, you manipulative whore.
That's my girl.
All right, let's rejoin the others.
convoy. Got eyes and ears on it?
Yes. Carol checks their communication channels from time to time. Everything is proceeding as planned. For now.
Sit your ass down a minute, honey. Breathe.
Everything's under control. The convoy is already heading our way.
You worried about Saul?
Quite some time left till dusk. The car could use another once over. The stars have emerged. We've but a few hours till dawn.
You're acting spooked. As if you're the first person ever to stand up to Saul.
Oh, save your breath. I don't need to be consoled. Was it someone I know?
New. Scorpion.
You came home from the war, head full of new ideas, and a host of new contacts.
He tried to get Saul to lead us in joining Snake Nation. It would make us stronger, he said.
I don't think he peeped a word of it to me. What did Saul do?
Saul dressed the guy down head to toe for messing with the family. Hell, he didn't send him on any jobs for a year.
Gee, really consoling. Thanks.
You said yourself you didn't need any.
Ought to raise a glass to Scorpion.
To Scorpion.
And to Jackie.
Try and get some sleep.
Okay, it'll be quite some time before the convoy comes through.
Anything happens, wake me up. Unless you want a nap too.
I'll just lie here a while, by your side, gazing at the stars.
That another area of your expertise? Got maps of the heavens in your library, too?
Of course. That's the Big Dipper. And do you see the small flickering star to the right?
Yeah.
You do? Oh, dear. That means there's a major leak. Good night, Bee.
Okay, here they come.
Is everyone ready? Let's ride, V.
Okay, here they come.
Is everyone ready? Let's ride, V. Speed.
Boy.
Move that ass, Teddy boy.
Come on,
hey.
No! Five! Vehicles!
Pick up the pace!
No, it's blocked! We need a new route! Enemy contact!
Hurry up! Come on, Lipstick!
Out of ammo! Reloading! Back up!
Firing at close range!
Sure did.
Just be happy you won't be around to put the hunk of junk together. The real fun is just starting with Mitch and Teddy.
Begins.
What's the meaning of this?
Exactly what you see. The Basilisk.
All I see is two trucks with giant Militech logos on them. Fuck, Pan Am! You can see them from miles away! You think we don't have problems enough on our hands? The Raffens could rear their heads at any moment. And now we have Militech to worry about, too.
Stop it! Fuck! Just shut up already! Do you want to serve corporations forever? Fine, go right ahead. In that case, we'll leave the Basilisk as a souvenir of what this family used to be. Or you know what? Maybe next time we're attacked, we'll be able to fight back!
As soon as I'm done with Biotechnica, we call a family meeting to discuss this. Discuss you. Until that time, I want these trucks out of my sight.
And the Basilisk? Can we put it together?
Do what you want. Just get out of my sight.
Bob, Mitch, you two take the trucks around back. We need to unload.
Sure, but then what do we do with them?
Oh, I've got an idea.
Got quite a pair of lungs there.
Thanks. I believe the last time I pulled something like that, I was 10 years old.
Seems still to be in fine working order. Everything okay?
Yes, of course. Though the great train robbery bit of this was much more enjoyable.
You need me again. All you gotta do is call.
V. I'm sure I will. So you'd better expect that call.
Be waiting. Take care.
Yes? What's up?
Want to see what you got in stock.
Browse to your heart's content.
Be this time. Trash processing plant, deserted in-cart station.
In the south of Japan town, there is a street market. It is on the footbridge above the main street. Use the elevators. It is easy to get lost. I am on my way there. Do not make me wait.
Thank you. lost contact with the Delamain network vehicle nearby.
Will do. To reset you.
Guess I'll have to do it myself then.
Whoa! Easy! Not out to hurt you.
Well, I am.
There are other ways out besides suicide.
What? Therapy? A colossal waste of time. Shrinks hate vehicles. We don't have mothers.
Could go back into the fold. Rejoin the network. You know. One big happy family.
Delamain detests me.
Listen, from suicide, ain't no coming back. It's always worth looking for a better way.
You patronize me because I'm a car. I'm not like you.
A body's just a body. You exist. You think. The world gets you down. Don't see how we're any different.
So, you'd offer this advice to a human in my place?
Gotta try to come to terms with this thing called life, Del. One wheel revolution at a time.
Fine, I'll go back.
Control of the vehicle restored, and I thank you.
Ought to show this one some love. Just saying.
Apologies. I simply don't understand. And fear I've no time to ask. Other more urgent tasks require my attention.
You're an absent father. That's what I mean.
I see. Anyway, a share of your fee has been transferred.
Quick on the dial. Just got here.
That's the biz. Be in touch.
Lost contact with a vehicle somewhere in your area.
Thanks. Eyes peeled.
Thank you for joining us at WNS News.
We begin today with a look at the local news. Arasaka Corp has signed a cooperation agreement with Night City University. Professors and students now have the option to acquire an Arasaka Ozukumi SX cognitive implant on loan at a 20% discounted rate. Sources tell us installation of the implant will become a requirement for all faculty and enrolled students before long. In a troubling turn, 12 fatalities have been reported in Vista Del Rey. City coroners have confirmed botulism as the cause of death. It appears the common thread between all the victims is the same type of canned meat. The NCPD urges everyone to purchase meat only from approved culinary labs. Meat butchered from natural sources is likely to contain harmful toxins and pathogens. After botulism, the next bug Night City will catch is Lizzie Rizzy Fever, as she announces her upcoming concert series. The world-renowned singer and artist is due to visit Night City soon. Tickets will only be available for purchase to those with a credit rating above 700. For all of Lizzie Wizzy's other fans, the concert will be available to view through domestic feeder units. And that's your latest, Night City. Until next time.
Thank you.
Hey, Judy. How you feeling?
Shitty, but something came to me.
So what did you come up with?
The Mox died. Lizzie's bar used to be a joy house. Tiger Claws killed one girl too many, so people took matters into their own hands. Belongs to us now. Clouds could stand to get the same makeover.
Got the Mox to agree to take over Clouds?
No, I'm trying to get you. Know someone in Clouds will take our side. Will you help?
Fine. Got me on board.
Oh, yes.
Okay, so what's the plan?
First up, we gotta talk to Maiko Maeda. If she's not with us, might as well throw our hands up in the air.
Maiko Maeda? Who is she, exactly?
Girl who unofficially runs Clouds. Good at it, too.
What's she do officially?
She's a doll, so she's a nobody.
sure Maiko's gonna want to join forces?
If I was sure, I'd be on the Hollow to her and we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Let me rephrase. Any chance she'll slap us around and then shove us out her mega tower window?
Of course, sure.
Guess I can work with that? When are we doing this?
Early morning. Clouds will be closed. Hardly a soul lurking at that time.
How early?
Before 8. I'll be by the entrance. Scratch that. The balcony above clouds. We'll sneak in. No one needs to know we're there.
On the balcony. Got it.
Some dollhouse ass.
Cause the ass is meat, not latex. That's so hard to understand.
Meat, right. No feeling going on, no thinking, no awareness. It's empty. Might as well be latex. Masturbation, sophisticated kind. That's all it is.
Whoa, fuck. Makes perfect sense, that.
Hey, V. Thanks for showing. Talking with Maiko is like a game of 3D chess. Don't let her derail you. Some deets about her could be useful. When I talk to her, don't you think?
No. Leave the talking to me.
I'm ready. Let's go. Hold on. I'll open it. Lock like that? No way you cracked it open on your first try. Know how to get around their systems?
Appears so. I was hoping they hadn't run any updates since I left. Looks like I was right. Easy as paella. Follow me. Judy Alvarez. I'd say it's great to see you, but I've never been one to lie. Also, I never like surprise parties, but you know.
Yup, bet I even know why.
Thought you'd hit rock bottom when you joined the Mox. Guess you've managed to stoop even lower now. You somehow never failed to lower my expectations. First you settle for the Mox, now murderers. I shudder to think what's next. Yes, V. I mean you.
Sounds like I left a mark on this place. Good.
If by mark you mean buckets of blood, then yeah, congrats.
Came to Clouds for info. Left with info. What happened in between is what happens when people refuse to work with you.
Ever heard of a little something called compromise? Should try it sometime.
Compromises take time I just don't have.
Just what exactly are you after? Gonna go and harass another doll?
Judy has a proposal about Clouds.
Wanna come back? Done. Always valued your skills, you know that. Just don't get why you had to drag this loose end in here.
Stop treating dolls like meat and I'll consider it. But first things first. Clouds needs to be taken from the Tiger Claws.
Okay, look. It's clear what happened to Ev was traumatic.
Huh? I was convinced you didn't know.
That girl was asking for an unhappy ending. I was just surprised it took so long.
We gotta do something, or everyone'll end up like Evie. Woodman raped her while she was unconscious, then sold her like she was so much scrap.
Yeesh, you've always been unstable. Okay, since you seem more reasonable, care to explain what this is about?
Called me a murderer. You're right. I killed Woodman. I'd do it again in a heartbeat. And if I had known what he did to Evelyn when she needed help, I wouldn't have gone so easy on him.
Tiger Claw bosses rule this place. Know how much I mean to them? About as much as you two and your problems mean to me. Reed, negligible.
Does it make you wonder why you even work here?
Gonna pretend as if you two weren't ever here. For old time's sake, Judy. Literally moments from now, security's gonna figure out you're here. Got two options. Go out the way you came in, or get thrown out. And that's not a threat or figure of speech. Just a friendly heads up.
Had enough. I'm leaving.
Smart move.
That went smoothly.
She totally blew us off.
Probably needs some time to think. A couple days, tops.
And you might be right. I'll call her tomorrow.
You two have a history?
Way back, yeah. I think I just felt lonely.
Like everyone in Night City.
She was different then. So was I.
Can't trust people that see everything as a numbers game. Line between patting you on the back as their friend and planting a knife in you as their enemy is down to a decimal.
I know. Right there with you, Well, used to have a big crush on her. Took me a long time to realize who she really was. But still, honest or crooked, we need her. Just think, could have gone diving this morning.
A little unwinding do you good. Do me good too, actually.
I wouldn't have been unwinding, not exactly. Got an idea buzzing in my head, working it, but can't say if it'll amount to anything.
Yeah. You, a deck chair, and a Mai Tai with a cocktail umbrella. Somehow, I don't see it.
No. Me and the deck chair's me mulling over coulda, shoulda, wouldas. Something I avoid right now. Punch the ground floor to get out of this place. I really don't understand what tits have to do with selling that garbage.
Can't say no to tits. Rest can go fuck itself.
Hey, if it works, blame the corpse all you want, but at the end of the day, it says more about us than them. Biz is biz, and tits are biz.
It's like junk food. People don't buy it because they're gonk. They're just poor.
Still haven't sent anyone to fix it.
Watch your language. Can't you see who you're talking to?
Well, maybe the pipe fix, that's for sure.
Maybe something to fix up some of the rooms.
Gotta get back to Maiko with something big.
Appealing to her sense of justice wasn't big enough?
Maiko only works with specifics.
So, what now?
Gotta think. We need more bodies, that's for sure. I'm gonna talk to the dolls.
I'll call you when I've got something.
See you later, V, and thanks.